probably write it. We'll see.
Oh, yeah.
I started early.
Security being a hassle for you upstairs?
Yep. Well, Richard got a little. And then he just turns into straight black and white, like you're either in or out.
The rules have been changed that many times.
Well, the thing is, once the first ice time starts, think of it as a public rink. Like, parents can come and go.
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't quite.
That's why I said, I understand what the tight ass NHL teams do on the ice, but they're
correct. Yeah, you know, once there's already a group on the ice and there's public, there's people from the public watching this game, like, why does it matter? Like,
you have to talk really loud to him, too, if you have to hear that one out.
Yeah.
Because he is pretty deaf.
Yeah.
But yeah, I hear you. But I'll really be able
to. We had the alumni come here one day, a few weeks back at the end of October, and he wouldn't let him down. Mike Craig, I had people calling me, like Kale calling me, and
you know,
yeah. Wayne had called me once or twice, and he's like, what the hell's going on? Like, because it was Kale's group, not mine, but I had given Kale all the info and told security and everything, and then he acted like he had no idea they were showing up and went down. The waivers aren't even their responsibility. They're Coyote waivers.
Yeah.
And second of all, the alumni are like, adult stuff on Sunday night.
Right. A lot of California folks.
Yeah. This program here, this Ventura Mariners, they brought like their entire program.
Oh, so how many different levels?
They just brought like 6 or 7 types.
That's pretty much every single level.
Pretty much, yeah.
Using all the ice now.
Oh, yeah. Not most. They're not using Peoria, I don't think.
Scottsdale Channel over here.
Yeah, Scottsdale Channel is over here. They're just playing the 2 games here. That's only because we give it to them for free for all the ticket business they send us. And they'll do it. This Ventura team, probably 6 or 7.
So, 300-400 people in that.
Yeah, because they did majority of the buying. So, yeah, we're just shy of 400 tickets between all the tournament teams. Yeah, that comes out to around 18 grand in tickets. So, we give them the 2 sheets
now. This is our last game at this tournament.
Between that and the ice free ice we give them, they give me access to the entire registration list. So I can get like team manager contact info and phone numbers and emails, and I can reach out to these teams and sell them tickets. Yeah.
How many local teams?
In this tournament, probably 25. The big tournament's in February, President's Day weekend. There's 170 teams, 175 teams, and 130 of them are out of state.
What's that on? What organization?
Arizona Hockey Union.
Oh, it's
Arizona.
Yeah.
Hey, are you involved with the Grand Canyon University State game in a couple weeks?
Yeah.
Is that a game or just a game? Okay.
Playing, yeah, I'm playing AU.
Grand Canyon does?
Yeah. And a D2 and a D3 team.
So we're treating some ASU game for all those pussies?
No.
No.
No, we're going to have like a PA announcer and maybe some music on. It's not going to be like a. There's no paid admission. It's not like, we're not bringing out like ice brew or anything. There's no TV cutouts. It's just like, you know.
Okay, so we're not doing any shoveling, but there's going to be just a cut between the period.
Correct, yeah. That's the only difference, is they're going to get cut between the periods.
Okay, so I don't need to see a second.
Yeah, I was actually going to this coming week, I'm going to send all the info. How's that bringing up our meeting? Yeah, other than cut between periods, that's about it. The only difference on your guys' end.
I'm still just listening to them. Okay, these guys, they help start the first as well. They're trying to do the same thing here.
This will be 14U.
Some of the names seem